Hey everyone, so today we are doing a very exciting video. In this video, we are going to be overusing the word cute. I can almost guarantee it. A little over a month ago, I was basically on a
rampage
of buying the most adorable handmade pieces from small businesses. And I'm doing an entire haul of it today. I cannot wait to finally unbox this stuff, you guys. The sheer mass of adorable things you can find handmade, I'm actually obsessed. Like, it's a problem, but it's a good problem. It's a good thing. So you guys probably already saw from the title, but yes, today we are going to be doing a huge unboxing of pieces I bought from small businesses. And like, I have a huge appreciation for like the craftsmanship, like making things by hand takes, because you guys have seen, I have been the worst at sewing. I have tried my hand at tie-dyeing. I'm currently learning pottery, which actually is like weirdly going well, so that's good. And back when I was like 12, I actually had my own little small business where I would go to markets and sell bracelets. So I've tried my hand at it. I love it. I love handmade, homemade, one-of-a-kind pieces. So I'm very excited to dive into this stuff. Everything, I already said, it's so cute. Like, seriously, I don't want to spoil it, but like, these pieces are adorable. You probably will want to buy some. But okay, I think without further ado, let's get into this haul video. Let's get unboxing. I cannot wait any longer. Let's begin. Let's go. Also, this is the first video I'm filming since my tooth extraction. I actually ended up getting a dry socket. If you're in the medical field, you probably know what that is, or if you've had one before, it's quite painful. Mine is like dying down a lot because I got it packed with like a gauze clove thing. Anyways, TMI, or nobody cares. But anyways, so it's still a little bit painful to talk, but honestly, the show must go on. I cannot wait any longer to unbox this stuff. I'm going to do it in no order. Let's start with this one. I guess I took it out of the mailing package. I don't know why I did that. Everything from small businesses is packed so cute. The pride of ownership these sellers have is just, it's admirable. It's very cute. Like this ribbon, it's cute. I should do my hair up with it. Oh my gosh, why does this actually look kind of good? Should I do it like this? See, you can repurpose it. Okay, but for real, let's dive into this. Oh my gosh, the crochet sloth plant holder. I'm obsessed with this, you guys. Okay, crocheting is something that I've actually never done. I have done knitting before. I don't really know what the difference of those are, but I did knitting way long ago, probably when I was like 10 or something. My grandma taught me how to knit and I quite liked it, but everything I would knit was like really wonky and messed up, so I drifted away from it. But I have this new thing with like crochet stuff. So adorable. This little sloth, it's supposed to be like a plant holder, but you could put anything in it. Like it could be hanging at the front door and you could put like keys or like your wallet in it. It is so adorable and it's so well made. Like it's so nice and thick. Seriously, this is so cute. Somebody made this like by hand. This is so good. So much talent here and it's just so adorable. I can't wait to hang this somewhere. I'm gonna get a little planter and maybe kind of like a droopy plant that'll grow out the sides and the little sloth will hold it. I love it. Okay, next, I believe that these are candle holders. Now this was from a more like well-known Etsy shop, I guess. I don't really know how it works. Like there was just this brand had quite a few sales. Oh, it came with candles. Yeah, these are candle holders, but I didn't know that it was gonna come with candles. That's nice. Okay, so there are three candle holders and they are so beautiful. Candlesticks, whoa, oh my goodness. Candlesticks are like coming back so intensely. I don't know when was the last time they were in, but it feels like it was quite a long time ago. And like, they are back with vengeance. They are everywhere right now. I mean, literally, like, look, I have one right here. Here are those three candlestick holders. They are in all different wood stains. I don't know if it's different wood or if it's just different stains. I almost feel like it's actually different wood. It smells so good. Oh my gosh. Like, I love the smell of wood. And this smells so good. It kind of actually smells like back when I used to figure skate, like in the change room. I don't know why. So adorable. Like this is elevating my style. Like my backdrop, I feel like is pretty cute, but like this on there, that would be extra, extra cute. The talent. It smells great. Okay, I remember these. There's a thank you card in here. for choosing Handmade and supporting my shop. Hope you like your purchase. Please do not hesitate to contact me if you have any questions or concerns. I believe that these are more candlesticks, as I was saying. They're coming back, and I am loving it and accepting them with open arms. Aw, it's all wrapped up cute. It's a lot of work to wrap things like this. Now, I believe, if I remember correctly, these are painted candlesticks. So it's more of like a normal candlestick, but then they take the time to paint them so beautifully. Look at that. I'm obsessed. Oh my gosh. That is such a cool idea, to take candlesticks, which are becoming so popular, and to just paint them with this nice design. On these are kind of like, I would guess, a yellow rose. I'm not a flower expert, so I'm not really sure. That would look adorable in the candlestick holders that we just got. Like, these are so cute. I like these because they kind of like make me think of like old school, like 1960s, but it's also like a modern twist. Like, I don't know, am I just reading into these too much? I just think they're beautiful. Oh my goodness, this. Okay, as I was mentioning to you guys, I have been diving into pottery, and I have seen your guys' comments on Instagram that you want to see a pottery video, and I'm actually planning on filming one next week, so that'll be coming out very soon. I'm very much an amateur, but you know, I'll share my journey with you. We can learn together. But this was a pottery piece that I just fell in love with. Oh my goodness, so cute. And this is the type of pottery that you wouldn't need a wheel to make. Like, I'm pretty sure that they would have just made this like with their fingertips or with like a few little tools, not a wheel. And then they put a little face on here, and it's like a little jewelry dish. Like, you can put whatever you want in here, but I'm gonna use it for a jewelry dish because I don't have anywhere to like set my jewelry, and sometimes it makes me nervous when I'm just setting it on a counter, because the amount of times I've set it on a counter and then later I'll find it on the floor and I'm like, someone hit this onto the floor. I need somewhere safe to put it. This little star will be perfect, and this is just so adorable. Seriously, when I saw this, hold me back. Like, I just love seeing how it's like handmade. Like, there's a few spots that you can see the brush strokes. The star isn't like a perfect star shape. Like, you can really see the craftsmanship in here. I'm so excited about this. It might be one of my favorite pieces, to be honest. Like, I want to make stuff like this. Okay, so the next piece is wrapped very beautifully. I think this was like a 3D printed planter. It's called Ball Plus She. That's apparently their Instagram. That's cool. Is this little like card 3D printed? Wow, that's so cool. 3D printers have always been kind of fascinating for me. Like, watching a 3D printer print something cool is really fun. Oh wow, they have business cards and everything. Thank you for supporting us all the way from Canada. We hope you enjoy using Riz. Is that his name? Is that the planner I bought? They have a name. And make you smile every day. Please leave a review when you can and share us on your socials. Very cute. I'm sharing you on my socials right now. My biggest social. It's wrapped up so nicely. I think that this was a brand from Australia, which is so cool. Oh my gosh. This is a 3D printed planter. Sorry, my eyes are actually watering because I'm getting so excited about it. It is 3D printed. Like, I can see all the little lines and everything going through here. It's actually really cool because, like, listen. Like, the 3D printer has like such texture. Very cool. And then it's a little planter guy and he's going like this. So on the product pictures, there was actually three different faces and designs you could get, and if you had all three, they would look so adorable together. So I'm definitely going to plant something in here. And it's pretty deep, which is nice, because there's lots of room for roots to grow. Oh yes. Literally right after this, I must go get some more plants, because I'm going to be planting all weekend. I'm obsessed. Like, looking at all my stuff right now on the table, I'm just like getting overwhelmed with excitement. Okay, this piece, I'm not 100% sure why I felt like I needed this so badly, but I don't know. I just thought it was really interesting. See, this is the one thing that I'm like, is it handmade? I'm not sure. Some of them I'm like pretty sure, but when it's in a bag like that, I get a little bit confused. We sincerely appreciate your love and support. We hope our service and product will delight you. Cozy and chill, nice. So basically, you're probably looking at this and you're probably confused. Let me enlighten you. It's like a fun play on eyesight, I guess. Like, in the product picture, you can see that it looks like the flowers are in almost like a cartoon vase, but really they're just in a normal basic glass vase, which I actually will have to get. I thought that it came with it, but I guess I'm gonna have to buy one that sizes up in here correctly. But then when you go on like this side, you're like, wait, what? Where did the vase go? Oh, there it is. I'm confused. Let me reach through. Oh, wait, it's not. It's just like a piece of wire put together in the shape of a vase. Can you tell this was like late night shopping? Like, this wowed me. It was probably like 1 a.m. and I was like, what? Vase? But not a real vase? What? I don't know. I thought it was really cool. I feel like it's also kind of a fun statement. Like, you don't see this all the time. So we'll see. My house is gonna be pretty decked out with stuff after this. Okay, next we have actually 2 little pieces. Let's see. Thank you for choosing Nicole's Nifty Knots. I hope you like the cactus coasters as much as I enjoy making them. Literally explain how much they like making them. That is so cute. Like, I love buying them. Okay, another crocheted piece. Now, some people say coasters are like not used anymore. I am like an avid coaster user, not because I'm really nervous to like get the like watermark on the table. It's more than that. My cup, I swear, like doesn't spill as much if it's on a coaster. I don't know why. I don't know. Maybe it's just weighted down better. There's probably nothing, no, I don't know. It makes no sense. I just love coasters, okay? So these coasters are cactus inspired. So adorable. They have like the little bloom on them. Each one has a different color. These are made so wonderfully. And then the thing that really sold me, which I don't know why it sold me so much, but like the fact that this came with a little bag to put them in, that sitting in my living room, I don't know. There's something about that. It's adorable. And like, they love making them. I love supporting them. This is adorable. 100% I'm gonna be using these. And I just feel like this is the type of piece that you have out and people will like ask, oh my goodness, where's that from? Like, that's so cute, you know? And I will direct them to this seller. Oh my goodness, I already know what this one is because it smells so good in here. This is candles. Whoa, hold me back when it comes to candles, you guys. Like, I am so obsessed with candles, but I'm like too obsessed to light them, which is such a vicious cycle. But okay, these are Brighter Sky Natural Soy Candles, packaged adorably. What is this? A freebie! This is so nice! Oh my gosh! Literally, they put in a freebie that looks like a mango. Are you joking right now? I'm like, my eyes are watering again.
That is so nice.
They did not have to do that. That is so cute. Because when I was shopping, I remember looking at the mango one and being like, should I? But like, freebie. And it smells so good. Like, it smells like the best, freshest mango I ever did smell. Okay, but that wasn't the one I ordered. This is the one I ordered. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh! First of all, that smells amazing. That is like the freshest smelling candle I have ever smelled. Wow, that's awesome. Okay, so as you can see, this is a little cake candle. I'm obsessed. So it's got like the lightest pink icing and then all of these little pieces on here, and it actually has a wick, like you can melt these. I don't know if I'm gonna melt them. I think it's just beautiful sitting there. I don't wanna wreck it. But I'm sure like that's what they're for. You're supposed to melt them, right? Like, it's not just a decor piece. I don't know though. It's gonna be really hard to light this. Like, I love it. Oh, that is so adorable. Just sitting there. Oh my gosh, and it matches my shirt. Okay, then I ordered 2 more candles. I went a little crazy. Yeah, it's true. I did. But like, you know, when you see stuff like this, it's just a little exciting. This is like a little mini balls candle. I just thought this was really adorable. And with all my like little windy candles, I think this will sit out just so adorably be like such a beautiful statement. I'm honestly gonna have to like redecorate my place around these candles because like they're beautiful. They should be the centerpiece. And then I got this candle, which actually looks like a piece of cheese with a strawberry on top, which is so cool because I actually watched Ratatouille the other weekend, and at that part where he's like, Remy's like eating the cheese and then a strawberry, I grabbed cheese and a strawberry and like it mixed so well, and this is an ode to that. Cheese and strawberry. Oh, it smells like Christmas. I was not expecting that. I actually picked the scents for those, like there's scent options, so I don't remember what I picked, but Christmas. Oh my gosh. Cacti coasters, you guys. I got more cactus coasters. It's weird, but like I have a like slight obsession with cactus stuff. Lots of my like family and friends have mentioned it to me and I really didn't notice. And then all in an instance, I'm like, yeah, actually everything that I'm like drawn to is like a cactus. I don't know why. Okay, but how this one works is, they're a little bit dirty. Oh, they've got like dust on them? Okay, they're a little bit dusty right now. I don't know how that happened, or like, it almost looks like they have like moss growing on them. Excuse me? How long were you guys being shipped for? Oh my goodness, okay, I have to rinse these off. They are like getting me all dirty. Give me 1 second. Okay, that was honestly a little bit weird, but let's do this now. Why can't I fit this in here? Like, I'm supposed to be able to fit this right in here. Okay, I'm just gonna be aggressive with it. Sorry. Oh my gosh, I'm like breaking it. What's happening? It just looks like I'm like trying to stick this in here, but it's just not gonna go. Like it just needs to be a little bigger. Like, you know what? I actually am just going to take a little, it's like a metal, I don't know what it actually is called. Oh, it's a metal file. And I'm just gonna file this out so that all this fits with ease. And then how it works is all the coasters like stick together. A little cactus like this. I mean, you can see it in the product picture, but then it's like this. And then when anyone needs a coaster, they just go ahead and grab them. I'd obviously push them down more, but they're wet, so they've kind of like expanded. But like, this is adorable. Like, they were a little dirty, but you know what? Who cares? They're a little dirty. I could clean them up. I'm not scared. Okay, last but certainly not least, I actually know exactly what this is, and I'm surprised that this is last because this is like something that I very much adore. Ah, you can see the little pig face sticking out. Okay, this is another like pottery piece. It's a handmade pottery little pig. How adorable is this? And like, how amazingly made is this? Like, seriously, I aspire to be able to make things like this. This is so adorable. I love the little pig face and like a little plant out here. So amazing. It's actually like a really cool, like, textured paint. I feel like looking at something like this would make you happy. Like, you wake up kind of on the wrong side of the bed, you look at this, it would be hard to be mad. That's all I'm saying. All right, guys, so that is everything that I bought from small businesses, but I have one ask of you guys. Do you have a small business? Would you be interested in me shopping on your small business? Because I would be interested in shopping on your small business. So please leave your link down below. Basically, I wanna do this video again, but I wanna shop at your guys' small businesses. So please link them down below and I will be doing some shopping. I absolutely love everything that I got. So adorable, so cute. They look just like the pictures, like even better in person to just have it in your hands. As always, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!